We switch focus now to that controversy that's breaking out of New Delhi. A former Prasar Bharati advisor has rubbished the INB minister Manish Tiwari's claims that the government never interfered in editorial decisions at Doordarshan. Speaking to Headlines today, the journalist Pranjal Sharma said that the INB ministry takes the final decision on all important editorial matters.
The Narendra Modi interview telecasted by Doordarshan has tilted the spotlight onto the reality of the autonomy that the Prasar Bharati organization is supposed to enjoy from its parent Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. I am now joined by someone who was a part of Prasar Bharati not too long ago. Pranjal Sharma, thank you for the time. My first question to you is, just what is the reality of the so-called autonomy that Prasar Bharati is supposed to enjoy?
In simple words, Jugal, Prasar Bharati has been set up under a separate act, but the act is weak. Ideally, in its original form, it was supposed to be as independent as the Central Bureau of Investigation, as the Chief Electrician Commissioner, as CAG, but the act itself is pretty weak. So I would say that Prasar Bharati has partial autonomy, not complete autonomy.
In terms of operations, can you tell us, for our viewers' understanding, as to just how does it translate in day-to-day operations? Because we're talking about an issue like an interview of Mr. Narendra Modi. So operationally, just how does it work?
See, Prasar Bharati is a policy-making body, and the DGs, the Director Generals of Akashwani, that is All India Radio, and Doordarshan report to the CEO. But the officials of both these organizations are really part of the cadre of Indian Information Service, that is part of the Ministry of Information Broadcasting. On a day-to-day basis, Prasar Bharati does not have anything to do with what's happening inside both Doordarshan in the news channels and the entertainment channels, as well as the at Akashwani and All India Radio. On policy matter decisions, a lot of them are brought to the notice of the board. The board takes the advice, the CEO issues the instructions and monitors whatever is going on. So today I would say that on some of the key matters, the ministry is still involved. If you want to launch a new channel, if you want to shut down a new channel, if you want to have extra capital expenditure, if you want to shut down something, the ministry is not is required. So Prasar Bharati acts today in a very strange place where it has actual dual control. The board of Prasar Bharati and the ministry is in constant tussle over controlling Doordarshan and Akashwani. Therefore, it really doesn't know what it is. Unless those fundamentals are changed, you will continue having these controversies where people have a right to say that, look, the government is interfering in the functioning of Prasar Bharati and its units, including DD News.
So let's just keep the Modi interview aside, but essentially what you're hinting at is that if there is something which is of contention and perhaps not to the pleasure of the ministry, there is every possibility that the ministry can and will have a say in just what goes on air, even though it's not supposed to.
Well, the ministry may not officially give directive for such micro level changes, because one particular interview in one channel and what should be said in that and what should be edited, I don't think the ministry would be involved, but there would be indications given, there would be messages given to some of the people who are in charge saying that, look, we would not like certain point of view to be put out. In any case, because it's a public service broadcaster, there are certain norms. Unlike private channels, the public service broadcaster will not go into malicious slander news. It will not cater to gossip. It will not cater to a lot of news which currently private channels think it's perfectly fine to put out.